Hey everybody, it's Randall from startappsblog.com, and today we're going to show you how to get up and running with Corona SDK. So first off, head over to coronalabs.com, and up in the top right-hand corner, click on the download button. Now this will take you into the standard login page. If you haven't already registered, go ahead and do so. Enter in a valid email address, password, confirm it, and then accept the terms and conditions of use and click on continue. If you've already done this, just re-log in with your email and password. So this will take you into the standard public release downloader page. If you're on Mac, you'll want to download the latest .dmg file. Otherwise, if you're using Windows like I am, you can download the latest .msi. At current, the latest build is 2015.2646. Just to let you know, you can also download the daily builds, which basically give you a more recent installer version with later features and bug fixes. But for our purposes, the latest public release would be just fine. Just click on the download button. That'll take anywhere from a few seconds to a few minutes, depending on your connection speed. I've actually already done that, so I'm just going to cancel that for now. And then head over to wherever you download it, the installer. Double click on it. That's going to come up with the standard installation wizard. Click on next. Accept the license agreement. And next. There's the default installation folder. And click on next and install. That brings up the Windows user account control. Click on yes. Okay, there we go. Now, if you leave that tick box in there, it's going to launch the Corona Simulator. So we'll just click on finish. And there we go. We've got the Corona Simulator come up. And also, it'll bring up the Corona Simulator output window, also known as the console. So first off, what we can do is open up the samples folder and run any one of these sample projects. We'll try this one here, Jungle Scene. So just double click on that. And what comes up is a landscape app shown on an iPhone 4. Okay, next up, what we need is a text editor to be able to write Lua code. So what I recommend is using the Corona Editor plugin, which is for Sublime Text. So if you head over to coronalabs.com/products and click on this Corona Editor tab, you'll get all the instructions on what you need to do. Just to help you out, I'm going to walk you through it here. All right, so click on the Sublime Text link. That's going to take you over to sublimetext.com, where you can use either version 2 or version 3. I'm actually going to be using version 3, which is still currently in beta. However, I've had no issues with it. So download whatever version you require for your OS. I'm going to be using Windows 64-bit. It's going to take a little bit of time there, so I'm going to actually cancel that. I've already downloaded it. And we'll just go to our downloads folder. There, I mistakenly actually downloaded version 2. We're going to use version 3, like I mentioned. Let's click on that installer. Here we go, the setup wizard, click on next. There's the default installation folder. And next, install. And there we go. That should be good. Now, the thing is, the Corona Editor plugin doesn't come with Sublime Text automatically, so you actually have to install something called the Package Control plugin. So we'll do that next. Let's click on the link, and the easiest way to install this package control plugin is to basically copy and paste this Python code into Sublime Text. So first, let's open up Sublime Text. And what you need to do first is go up to View, show console. And then you have this sort of white bar area down below. So let's go back to that section of code that we require. We'll just highlight that and control C for copy. And we'll just paste that in there and select enter. So what that's going to do is basically download all the required packages from the net, and we'll just wait for it to finish. So there, it's finished now. It's come up with one dependency that was required to be installed. Next up, what we need to do is go to the Tools menu under Command Palette, and we need to basically go to Package Control and Install Package, that option there. And we're going to do a search for Corona Editor, which, there we go, it comes up version 1.5.1 at the moment. So I'll just click on that. And there you go, it installs the Corona Editor plugin. And you'll see this new tab at the top of your menu come up, which is basically the Corona Editor plugin. And there we have it. So in the next video, we'll start using Sublime Text and Corona Editor to create our first basic app. See you then.